are proof, in a sense, of the evolutionary ancestry of the eye.
Eyes are imperfect because evolution does not create things the way a designer or an artist does. Natural selection simply favors random changes that make an organism more fit to survive. And imperfections in design often result from evolution's constant tinkering. One such imperfection proved traumatic for artist Valerie Young. Valerie had a retinal tear, not an uncommon problem due to the way human eyes evolved from light-sensing patches of brain tissue in our ancient ancestors. In the human embryo, eyes develop from bulges in the brain's neural tube that pinch in to form cavities. This top layer, the retina, which tore in Valerie Young's eye, contains cells that collect light. It rests against a second, darker layer that lines the back of the eye. But the two layers are not attached to one another. And when the jelly that fills the eye liquefies as we age, it can cause the retina to tear. The jelly can then seep into the space underneath, leading to a retinal detachment and, in some cases, blindness. Valerie Young's retinal tear is just one example of imperfections in the design of human eyes. Another occurs because nerve cells and blood vessels evolved to lie in front of the retina, where they interfere with its ability to form sharp images. It's like trying to take a picture through a foggy piece of glass. And the optic nerve itself evolved to connect to the brain through a hole in the retina. So the eyes of all vertebrates have a small blind spot, right near the middle of the visual field.
Evolution starts with what's already there, tinkers with it and modifies it, but can never do a grand redesign. So even the eye, with all of its optical perfection, has clues to the fact that its origin is of the blind process of natural selection.
Darwin believed that what he called an organ of extreme complexity, like the eye, could evolve by small steps, given enough time. Any trait that improved vision would aid in the search for food, or a mate, or in the avoidance of predators. So natural selection would most certainly favor those traits. Nielsen envisioned a sequence of stages by which a flat patch of light-sensitive cells on an animal's skin could evolve into a camera-type eye. As a first step, nature would favor any changes that made the flat patch more cup-like. The brightly lighted skulls cast an image onto a translucent screen Nielsen installs at the back of the cup to act like a retina. But the image is not at all well defined. The cup eye can do little more than detect movement. This kind of eye can be found in nature today, in flatworms. Their eyes evolved no further. In their environment, that's all they needed.
But if the animals need to move faster or evolve to become fast predators or to see other fast predators, then the construction needs to be improved. And one way of doing that is to constrict the opening to make it smaller.
That's just what happened to creatures like the chambered nautilus. Over thousands of generations, natural selection favored those with slightly more constricted eye openings, which focus light more sharply. This worked well, up to a point.
Since this strategy of making a sharp image also has the drawback of creating a very dim image, it's not very popular in the animal kingdom. And there is an alternative solution which has become very popular in the animal kingdom, the solution that we use in our own eyes, and that is to put in a lens.
Nielsen's model lens uses two thin layers of clear plastic. He can inject water in between them to make the plastic windows bulge out like a convex lens. This mimics what natural selection might have done over a few hundred thousand generations, favoring animals with a rounded, transparent layer in their eyes that cause light to be focused more sharply on the retina.
So we can make it gradually from no lens at all and just continue to inject more water, making the lenses bulge more and more, and the image becomes gradually sharper and sharper.
The extreme complexity of the eye left Darwin in a cold sweat, he wrote to a friend. But still, he was convinced that an eye could be formed by natural selection. He later wrote that eyes must have evolved by numerous gradations from an imperfect and simple eye to one perfect and complex, with each grade being useful to its possessor. Nature, unaided by a designer, could produce an organ of seemingly miraculous complexity.